Need something to tell. Would everyone please stand for the prayer by senior softball player Emmy Smith and keep standing for our national anthem.
Please bow your heads. Lord, we thank you for this day. I pray you will keep each player safe tonight and that both teams will show good sportsmanship to one another on and off the field. Thank you for bringing us here tonight for this game, and please keep a hand of protection over Delta Streets as they travel home tonight. Amen.
Delta Streets Lions won the toss, elected to receive. They'll be on the receiving end. Colts will be kicking off, working left to right on your radio dial.
All right, Bobby, let's see if I can't call a win tonight. I'm 0-3 so far. See if we can't get on the winning end of this.
Yeah. 0-3. Yeah, and Quincy's 4-0, by the way.
1-0. Let's go with 1-0.
No. He's
calling
no,
junior
no.
high. That's junior high.
Junior
that doesn't
high
count. That, no, we don't get to count the junior high games.
A win's a win. Yeah. Delta Streets is new to the conference from Greenwood, Mississippi. This is the first time we've lined up for a full game. Played them in the Jamboree. But kicked away, favored doing your kicking. Ball was skipped past the 15, fielded. He tries to get to the outside, and Spinks there pushing him out of bounds. I think Darren Williams also in there.
Yeah, not a bad kick. Good job on the coverage there by the Colts. They're going to set the Streets up at about the 30-yard line.
Yeah, I mean, anytime we can get them, you know, behind the 35, that's a win. I think we got most of the squad back in action. Brad Jennings, I think, is the only one nursing an injury tonight. So about as healthy as we can be. Well, come out and they – all right, snap, bad snap. Walker's trying to get there, and he's going to drag him down for a loss.
Yeah, great drive by – great job by Walker there. Got him in the backfield, held on to his jersey, and got him down for a big loss.
I think he ripped the sleeve off of him.
I think kids keep that as a souvenir, Bobby.
Yeah.
Pelt on the wall.
I think they're going to have to just – I think they're going to stop the clock and try to help the boy out in his uniform.
Got a uniform timeout.
All right, we'll take a quick break.
1980 Dunn Crop Insurance has been the premier provider of crop insurance in the Mississippi Delta. For revenue, wind and hail, or replant protection, give Mason Dunn or John Andrew Augustinelli a call at 662-649-8300 or visit them at 320 West Lee Drive, Clarksdale, Mississippi.
All right, I think they got the equipment sorted out. Clock's rolling 11:18 to go. It's second and about 25 for Delta Streets. They come out. He's trying to get around the corner, and he does. Spinks is there to chase him down.
I don't mean to bring up old memories, bad memories, Bobby, but right off the right-hand side, we got no contain over there. He cuts it up. It's about 10 yards there.
He found the hole there, and, I mean, we had all guys getting in the box. And a broken tackle there, and he would have been gone. Spinks doing a good job coming back. Ah, we're going to give him a free 5 yards.
Yeah, jump up front. That's going to make it a –
that'd be third and five.
About third and five for the Streets here.
Offside. You can call them the Lions.
Oh, the Lions. Yeah. Delta Street Lions.
Streets isn't the mascot.
Well, yeah, I was doing the best I could do with the information I've been given, Bobby.
The Lions.
But now here we go. The Lions. Here we go. The Lions, third and five. Here.
If you would show up on time, we could do pregame. But, you know, when you get here late, you kind of lose a little bit.
Can't study, can you?
Snaps away. Handoff up the gut. Mosier gets in there. Going to have him short of the first down. But it'll be a short fourth and one. We'll see what the Lions will do.
Yeah, he broke up the middle there, but great job by Will Mosier sticking him right there, bodying him up, getting him down before the line of game. Going to bring up fourth down.
Be fourth and one for the Lions.
Yeah, they're coming up in a loaded front. Giving it to some speedy, thrifty running backs, and they're just finding some creases. They'll send two receivers out, overload to the top side, snaps away. They give there, and we get there. Spinks is there to bottle them up.
Yeah, we
and,
got some.
I think that's Artis.
Yeah,
in
good
there with him.
Great penetration early. They got him slowed down, and Spinks cleans him up, and that's going to turn it over for the Colts.
Be first and 10, Lee Academy Colts.
Well, after last week, kind of getting pummeled. Up the middle. It's good to see a stop.
That ought to give the defense a little confidence there to be able to get some stops tonight.
Fave is your wide receiver. Artis Williams in the backfield with Walker under center. Snaps away. He's looking to pass. He's going to go deep. Trying to hit Fave. And he gets broken up. Fave went to high point the ball, a little short.
Yeah, he jumps up to go get it early, and it's a good job by the Delta Streets defender there to come back and get his hand in there to knock that away.
Well, I thought Tanner jumped a little early on that. But good to go ahead and get the deep threat in the playbook.
Yeah, now they've seen it, so now they got to work. They got to look for it.
Come in the wing formation. Snaps away. We're going to give to Williams on the speed, and he can't get the edge, and he's going to go nowhere.
Yeah, nothing doing there for the Colts on the little speed sweep. The Lions had that thing stretched out, and they had plenty of defenders there to bring him down for a loss.
Well, it's just I don't know if we got poor timing on it, but it's slow developing, and that play ought to be lightning quick. All right, we'll send Fave to the top. Strong right formation. Snaps away. We're going to give the Artis up the gut, and he gets bottled up. Gain of about three. Bring up fourth down.
And they go right up the middle there, and there was not a lot of push from the offensive line there. Delta Streets had that thing bottled up.
All right, Colts going to roll the dice early. We got 8:40 to go. We'll send Fava to the bottom. Artis and Williams in the backfield. Snaps away. We're going to go for it. We got a couple guys there. He hits the tight end. and he's going to push his way down into the 15-yard line. I know we had two guys open on that.
Yeah, a really good job by Redwine there. He found the open spot. He sat down. He made a big target for William Walker to get the pass out there. He makes a good throw, and they pick up the first down. Great job by the quarterback and the tight end there getting the first down.
It's good to see him. He just got out there and showed him his numbers.
Yeah, showed him. The target. He sat right there in the soft spot of the zone, and he was wide open.
All right, they're in a five-man front. Most guys in the box. Snaps away. We're going to give up the middle, and Artis is going to find a little bit better running room, a gain of 8 on first down.
Yeah, a big run right up the middle there for the Colts. Good job by Artis just pushing forward, using those legs, getting all the yards he can get.
All right, we got number 8, Sandy Tillis, checking in for Artis.
Be second and one for Lee Academy.
Good push there by the offensive line and the Colts.
I think in this set, Darren's going to be the fullback. Snapped away. We're going to give it to Tillis. And they just come off the edge. Two or three guys unblocked.
Yeah, nothing there for Tillis to do. Wasn't much he could, wasn't any lane for him to hit there. So he gets tackled in the backfield. Good job by the Lions there, getting penetration and bringing him down early.
Well, it's a lot of attention to the run game. It's a lot of over pursuing. You know, just a quick out by Moser would be pay dirt. Snaps away. Here he goes. Throws it there. Touchdown.
Oh, there it is. Good job.
So that's not a touchdown. If we missed it, Moser ran out in the flats and got a touchdown, get the Colts on the board. Fava follows up with an extra point. Colts lead 7-0, 6:51 to go.
Yeah, good drive by the Colts. They got the fourth down conversion there to Redwine, who did a really good job of finding the soft part of that zone there that the Lions were running. And good drive there by the Colts after getting the early defensive stand to go up 7-0.
You know, and it never fails. I mean, last night I did the whole Pee Wee game. Nothing. Man, no trouble. I get in the junior high game, second play goes down. I'm like, you got it. All right, yeah, we're up and going. Who? Yeah. Colts will be kicking off. 6:51 to go. Good kick by Fava. It's going to get over his head, and it's going to go all the way down, and it's, he's going to get in the end zone. He was in the end zone, fella. And they're going to knock him out of bounds at about the 24. I mean, the guy stepped into the end zone. That's a touchback.
Yeah, I thought he might have there, Bobby, but they're saying he was just outside of it.
It doesn't matter if you get pushed into the end zone with the ball.
Host the Colts there, but they get him down at the 24.
Yeah, maybe the ball didn't cross the plane, but that's a little tight there.
Now, that was the 5-yard line you were looking at, Bobby. He was just outside. He was just inside the 5. Yeah.
Okay, my bad.
It's all good. Yeah. He was just inside the 5. Good coverage there by the Colts. They get him down, so they'll start. The Lions will start at the 24.
Yeah, good defensive series, the first for the Colts. Delta Streets, they come up pretty loaded, two receiver set, strong right formation. Snaps away. They're coming backside. Antis is there to get him out of bounds. Walker, trailing, Moser in the area too. Pickup of what, 3?
Yeah, about 3 yards. Good pursuit by the Colts there. They look like they're moving a little better on defense tonight. They would stretch that thing out, push him out of bounds before he could pick up any more yardage.
All right, we got a strong right formation overload. Snaps away. He's going to find the crease. And they're going to get a hold there in in the middle of the line.
Yeah, yeah, he found a little crease there to get some yardage, but it may have been due to a hold there, Bobby.
Yeah, well, you know, they've got four guys on that side of the center, so it's a little bit of an overload, and we're doing a good job getting a good initial stuff at the line, but quick running backs finding some creases.
Yeah, they got Peyton Burton playing linebacker there. They got him inching up every play, he's hitting his gaps pretty well, but it looks like there may have been, obviously, like there was a hold there. Going to push him back.
We got second and 15 for the Lions. All right, they send two receivers to the top, one to the bottom. Snaps away, looking for the pass. And it's a quarterback scramble. Walker's going to be there, Burton there. Spinks there. Walker got the biggest pressure, and Burton cleaned it up for him.
Yeah, Walker comes in early and makes him get off of his mark where he wanted to be, made him scramble, and then there was a host of Colts come in and clean him up there. They're not going to get any yardage on that play. So good job by the Colts defense. The pursuit looks good tonight. They look fast to the ball. There's a lot of guys around it. So much better effort tonight by the Colts on the defensive side.
I just sent a three receiver set, looking for the pass, looking for the screen, and it's going to be incomplete. Walker, Spinks, and I think that's Carlos in on the pressure, but Walker was there, had to get it over top of him. That sailed it.
Yeah, the pressure got there early and made him get rid of it a little quicker than he wanted to, but it's a good job by the Colts recognizing why they were in there so quickly, recognizing the screen, staying back and get a hand on it. Even I realize there's a penalty, but again, the defense was disciplined there. They didn't bite on it.
Yeah, I think that's a formation penalty, so we'll decline that and bring up fourth down.
I really do like how they stayed back. They stayed in their lanes, and they were able to tip that away. He catches that ball. He had a lot of room in front.
Moser back deep for the Colts. That's the way he kicks up. And it'll be short. It'll settle inside of Colt territory at the 46-yard line. Colts lead 7-0. We'll take a quick break.
When choosing a bank, wouldn't you prefer to deal with a local institution with years of loyal service to the community that it serves? That's precisely what you get with First National Bank of Clarksdale, Bank of Oxford. With over 50 years of service, our friendly staff has been providing the Clarksdale and Oxford areas reliable support with checking accounts, savings and loan opportunities, CDs, IRAs, and much, much more. With three easy and convenient locations in Clarksdale and two in Oxford, it's never been easier to be your hometown bank. First National Bank of Clarksdale, Bank of Oxford, member FDIC. Go Colts!
All right, we're just confirming instant replay did get Moser on
the
catch.
We got somebody in the chat, Tampa Bay Buccaneers fans, says, can anybody else not hear sound, or is it just me?
I don't know. Well, yeah. I had it on. You can tell them. All right, plays away. We skip it over to Favor. Yeah, we got back from the commercial break. I put it on mute because
Yeah, I don't know. Somebody in the chat said they couldn't hear anything, so I don't know if they weren't catching this or not.
It was on mute there for about, I don't know, 4 or 5 minutes.
But everything else, we've been good.
Yeah, okay. We should be good.
All right, well, Colt's going to bring up. It's going to be 2nd and 10 for the Colts here.
If you can't hear us,
let us know.
Yes.
Send us in the chat. I'm watching the chat. Let us know. Yeah, we'll try to fix it.
All right, Colts have it second and 10. Errant throw to Fave on the first attempt. And we'll get a timeout. Colts spend the first one of the half. 5:13 to go. Colts lead 7-0. We'll take a quick break.
Alec Bird, proud former Lee Academy football player and current agent at Delta Insurance Agency. Whether it's homeowners, auto, farm, commercial, life, or crop insurance, the experienced agents at Delta Insurance are here to guide you through your decision-making process to give you the peace of mind that your family and assets are protected. Give Alan Bird, Drew Brown, or myself a call at 662-483-1633.
All right, we're back live. Now, we had a water timeout as well, so.
And tell Lunsford to settle down. He knows how to find it. He understands how to go to YouTube and find a game, right?
That golf game must have ran late tonight.
Yeah, I think they had a big golf game today. But, hey, but Quincy's here, so Bradley should have had plenty of time to get home and get to the game. Unless he's collecting all that money.
I don't think he collects much of it. He just shoves it out the door.
Hands it out. All right, here we go. Second and 10 for the Colts.
Strong right formation. Moses, your H-back. Snaps away. We're going to give up the gut. And they've got them stacked in there. I mean.
Yeah, from what I've seen tonight, Bobby, I wasn't sure what to expect, but tackling has not been an issue for the Lions. At the point of contact, they're doing a really good job of getting the Colts down.
Well, the Colts have run a couple plays this season and run them very well, and they're keying on them, and that's all they're keying on. You got to go to the well. There's other avenues open. Counterplay would be perfect. And we run the quarterback keeper around the end, and there's some room, and Walker gets over, gets first down yardage.
Yeah, great job by your big quarterback there, kanking around the end. Used the speed to get outside any tackler out there to pick up the first down. Good job by your senior quarterback, William Walker.
Well, they're just overcommitting on the dive and the
well, they've seen that play from the Colts all year long coming up the middle. Yeah,
that's why you have these other plays to try to keep them honest. And if they want to keep overloading, we'll keep going that route. All right. Pass deep. Favors there, and he gets interfered with.
Yeah, that's going to be an easy flag.
Yeah, another short pass. So that one just came out of his hands odd.
Well, it
kind of wobbled.
He didn't get his feet set as all. He's trying to throw that on the run, and he didn't get all the oomph behind it that he needed there. But
it seemed like we're a little late on that throw.
Just a little. He had it early. He's got to get it away early. He's got to set and throw a little bit early.
Well, I
think he's waiting for Favre to clear.
Yeah, there's no need to wait. You know, he's setting up the defender. You try to get it to the spot. And we're just a little late there. And both of those shots that we've took, Tanner's had to come back to the football. So get out a little bit early and we'll be in better shape. Penalty gives us first and 10. Snaps away. We're going to run the counter. And it's open. And he gets down the sidelines. Picks up at least 9. Now he gets a solid 10 for a first down.
That's a great job by Moja there. He sidesteps a tackle and gets on the outside.
You got the hiccup?
Yeah, it's bad. Hold on. Let me get rid of that.
Be second and 1 for Lee Academy.
All right, not 10 yards. He got 9. 3:44 to go in the first quarter. Colts lead 7-0, looking to extend the lead. I think we're on about the 19-yard line, 18. Snaps away. We're going to look for the pass again. Now he throws it early, and we drop it. You know, I don't know if Tanner was thinking, hey, I'm getting a little close to the sidelines, but that's just a pure drop. We got to catch that ball. Great placement by Walker. We had it 3rd and 1.
Yeah, the best pass that Walker made tonight, and then Flava had it in his hand, just couldn't corral it.
I felt like Walker got that one out early, caught Fava coming out of his break. He just dropped it. Snaps away. All right, we got the quarterback coming over the middle, and that's hits Redwine, and I think he gets in for the touchdown. 87, Jonathan Redwine from his tight end position hits a drag route.
Hey,
scores a touchdown.
I'm so glad to see Redwine get in the end zone. He's been running good routes all year. We just hadn't been getting in the ball enough. The good throw by Walker there, and he finds him open. A good catch by Redwine and falls into the end zone for six.
Well, they're committing everybody in that box. They got no safety. So, you know. Little Gronk. Kick is up.
Well, like
no
I mentioned,
good.
From what I've seen all year, he's running good routes. It's just whether we have enough protection for Walker to find him.
All right, we'll take a quick break.
The Academy Colts are proudly supported by Triple M Crop Services. Local and family-owned, Triple M has provided sound service to its customers for over 25 years. Stop by and see Chris or Thornton Marley at 560 Friars Point Road in Clarksdale. Or give Chris a ring at 662-902-4297 or Thornton at 662-902-515.
It's big. It's good. His hands are good. His hands are good. He's got good hands.
All right, Colts will come out of the break. We'll be kicking off.
Yeah, if they come through.
To Delta Streets. Favor doing your kicking, dude. We got Williams out there, Humber, Walker, Peyton, Spinks, Diaz, Dixon, Moser, Antisi, and Artis.
All right, I apologize for that, fans. I think I had a little hiccup issue. Sorry about that, Bobby. I think I'm back in the game now. I think we're ready to go.
Well, you just got excited we may win this game.
Yeah, maybe that's it.
Kick it away. A nice booming kick. Caught on the run. Humber's there, and he hits a seam. And we're trying to get to him, and we don't. He cuts it back, and he steps out of bounds at the 27-yard line, 28-yard line.
I think it caught us off guard that he caught that on the run. A really good job by the Lions player there to catch it on the run and come up and hit the seam early, and we had nobody in coverage there. So good job by the Lions and good job by the Colts finally pushing him out of bounds.
Just too much spacing. By the gunners on this side and left too big a crease.
Well, I don't think they were expecting him to catch that on the fly.
All right, Lions will start in Colt territory, first and 10 from the 28. Colts lead 13-0. 3 minutes to go in the first quarter. Empty backfield, snaps away, they're going quarterback run. Burton tries to get in there, misses. And then we got Burton in there, Malkop, and I think Diaz in there.
Yeah, really good job by 50 there cleaning that up after he got in there for about 2 or 3 yards, and 50 comes in there, sticks him hard, and takes him down for a short game.
We got to be disciplined on the ends. Getting in that speed formation. And they got pretty good speed.
Just want to see good pursuit, good angles, not giving up the big holes tonight. Just improvement over the Kirk game.
Snaps away. They're going to wildcat it this way. Artis is in the backfield. And the Holster Colts get him down.
Yeah, the defensive line really crashed that whole left side down, right side down for the Lions, and he had nowhere to go.
You know, they're giving us an overload look on the right side, and the Colts are putting an extra man down, matching up fairly well on that side. Third and 7 for the Lions. Here comes the speed. And they run back door. Good fake on the speed. run the counter play and gets good yardage.
Yeah, good job. Peyton Burton field early right there, and he gets him down. He's going to force a fourth down. Good job by Peyton Burton coming back after he'd kind of gone upfield a little bit. Comes back, makes a tackle. Good job by Burton there on the tackle.
Well, it was
to
my,
force a fourth down.
It was my expectation that they would run the speed there. They'd kind of been working up to it. So good play call with the counter. Now they'll come out in a three-receiver set. And they're going to try to get us off sides. And Colts hold the water. And we'll catch a quick break. Lions timeout.
Security and Satellite is a proud sponsor of the Lee Academy Colts. Since 1999, Shannon Dixon has been providing all of your alarm, camera, and home audio system needs. Give Shannon a call at 902-4181 to tailor your security needs.
We got time for another break.
Since 1980, Dunn Crop Insurance has been the premier provider of crop insurance in the Mississippi Delta. For revenue, wind and hail, or replant protection, give Mason Dunn or John Andrew Augustinelli a call at 662-649-8300 or visit them at 320 West Lee Drive, Clarksdale, Mississippi.
An elephant and then it all.
I think so. Right, fourth and four out of the break. Overload to the right, two receiver set. Looking for speed this way, and it looks like they may have had a false start. Pushing back 5 yards, be second and nine. Or fourth and nine, sorry.
Yeah, that little early movement there for the Lions. It's going to move them back. It's going to make it a little more difficult here on the fourth down. But look, they appear to still be going for it here on fourth down.
Yeah, fourth and nine. We got about 50 seconds to go in the first quarter. Colts looking for a stop. Lions break huddle. They send two receivers to the bottom. Overload to the top. Snaps away. Pop pass. And he's going to get up the field, but not anywhere close to the first down yardage.
Yeah, good job by the Colts secondary. Come up, get him out of bounds before he gets the first down. It's a nice little play there, hitting the pop pass by the Lions, but Colts sniffed it out to get him stopped short. Colts going to take over first down.
Yeah, 43 seconds to go. Let's see if we can maybe get a big play here. We hadn't had any big plays, just kind of methodically getting down the field. The best play of the night has been to the tight end. So maybe a slant here will look good to favor. Snaps away. And we're going to just do the quarterback buck. He's got room, cuts it up. He gets across the 40, down to the 44-yard line. Great run by the quarterback, William Walker.
Yeah, you got a feeling that play's going to be there all night long, Bobby. They have, as soon as he makes the fake, they got nobody there. They're crashing down inside. And as soon as he hits the outside with his speed, they got nobody there to bring him down.
Yeah.
Easy little run to the outside by your senior quarterback, William Walker.
Just the over-pursuit, and that's just a quarterback counter off of it. So, good play call. Snaps away. We're going to give to Artis. He's going to pick up about 3 yards on the play. I mean, that's good first down yardage.
Yeah, I don't hate the play call. You're going right into the teeth of their defense and what they're trying to do. But, again, he picks up 3 or 4 yards there. So, good hard run by Artis.
I think that's Williams on the carry there.
Oh, Darren Williams
on
the carry
bad.
There? Okay.
And that'll do it for the first quarter. Your Colts lead 13-0. We'll take a break. In action, and be back for second quarter.
Albert Bird, proud former Lee Academy football player and current agent at Delta Insurance Agency. Whether it's homeowners, auto, farm, commercial, life, or crop insurance, the experienced agents at Delta Insurance are here to guide you through your decision-making process to give you the peace of mind that your family and assets are protected. Give Alan Bird, Drew Brown, or myself a call at 662-483-1633.
Lee Academy Colts are proudly supported by Triple M Crop Services. Local and family-owned Triple M has provided sound service to its customers for over 25 years. Stop by and see Chris or Thornton Marley at 560 Friars Point Road in Clarksdale, or give Chris a ring at 662-902-4297 or Thornton at 662-902-514.
Colts will start the second quarter. Second eight. Snaps away. We're going to hand off. Try to do the cutback. And, you know,
yeah, they sniffed that out early. Right to everything their defense is trying to do. And they were there, and they get him stopped. They bring him down. Another good tackle by the Lions there.
Well, I mean, you run the counter, the quarterback keep, trying to say, all right, we got these other plays.
Yeah.
And then you go back to the workhorse, and they're going to continue to not let that play beat them. So we just need to keep the wrinkles going. Tall sweep would be available. Snaps away. We're looking for a pass. Moser's open. And Moser was open.
We he missed him early, yeah. I don't think the quarterback turned his head quick enough. Moser was open early. A little quick pass there, and you got him easy for the first down.
Yeah. Like he fixated on Fava there.
Yeah, I think he wanted. I think he wanted the bigger play there. But
yeah,
if you caught him early, you would have found Moser easy there for the easy third down conversion.
Colts will punt. Walker's doing your kicking duties. Snaps away. And we're going to fake punt. We're going to throw it over to Darren Williams, and he makes the catch. He stays on his feet. And he's going to matriculate, and he's going to get in down to the 1 yard line. But we got a flag.
I think we might have started just a little early on that play.
Well, I mean, if it was a false start, they'd have blown it dead. They're going to probably get us with an illegal formation. So I don't know if we didn't have enough guys on the line of scrimmage or what.
Heck of a catch by Williams there. Bobbed a little bit, brought it back to himself.
Yeah, maybe they'll talk themselves into letting us keep the football at the 1 yard line.
Got a little help from his teammate out there to keep him up, keep him upright, keep running, keep churning. They're going to sort it out. We'll see what we get here on the penalty.
All right, we got enough guys on line of scrimmage, so I don't know what they're going to debate here.
I don't think they understand why they threw the flag, but they're having a conversation about it, Bobby.
Are they going to wave it off?
No flag on the play.
I mean, I think that's what he was thinking.
Illegal procedure. Not enough guys on the line.
They didn't have enough guys, illegal formation. And after consulting with the other guys, they said, no, they had enough guys. So, big play by Williams on an acrobatic catch. Colts will get the ball down to the half-yard line.
Walker put it where nobody else could catch it, but Williams was able to haul that thing in. It was a great catch by Williams there. He got a little help, put his partner downfield to keep him upright, get down inside the 5 yard line. They have a first and goal just inside the five.
We got the Delta Street coach pleading his case, trying to.
Oh, I can imagine he's not real happy about the waving the flag off.
I mean, you don't see a lot of flags waved off. So
he got his explanation, and I'm sure he's not real happy about it, but we're going to play on.
We're a little bit further out than I thought. I'm having trouble seeing the lines tonight. Yeah, we're just, about the three.
Yeah, just
maybe
in
the four.
Just inside the five.
Motion. Snaps away. Quarterback gonna keep around that side. And yeah, we had a Williams held on the outside. No need to hold there.
No, that play's been open all night, but they're gonna get us on a hold here and push us back.
Yeah, the guy kind of slipped under him, and Williams just stuck his paw out and held him. And you got to let your 6'3 quarterback run over somebody.
Yeah,
he's got to block them all.
Yeah, he's there. He's got enough build to him to run over a couple of guys there. That play was wide open. It just there was no need to hold. Just they caught us getting it, so
we'll
make it push us back.
We'll make it more difficult on ourselves. It's still first and goal. But now we're on the 13-yard line. Snaps away. Handoff up the gut. And Artis finds a seam there.
Yeah, he caught a little seam right up the middle. The offensive line did a great job giving him a little seam, and he hit it hard and good hard running by Artis there to get down. He got all the penalty yardage back, so we're just back inside the five now. Second down and goal from about the 4.5.
Well, you know, When they come up in different fronts, the linemen have to talk and figure out who's got who. So maybe we fix some missed blocks there. Motion by Moser. Snaps away. We're going to quarterback keep. He's going to cut up. He's going to get in the end zone.
Yeah,
touchdown, William Walker.
Easy run by Walker there. Again, that play's going to be there all night when you need it. You don't want to get your quarterback hit too many times, but when the play's there, you got to take it when you,
he's tough
when you got it.
He's tough enough. If he can't handle it, I refuse to say he can't handle it.
Yeah, really good job by Walker there.
All right, Fava doing your kicking. Snaps back, kick is up. Kick appears to be good. Fava 2 of 3 on the night on extra points. Colts lead 20-0. We'll catch a quick break.
1980 Dunn Crop Insurance has been the premier provider of crop insurance in the Mississippi Delta. For revenue, wind and hail, or replant protection, give Mason Dunn or John Andrew Augustinelli a call at 662-649-8300 or visit them at 320 West Lee Drive, Clarksdale, Mississippi. Security and Satellite is a proud sponsor of the Lee Academy Colts. Since 1999, Shannon Dixon has been providing all of your alarm, camera, and home audio system needs. Give Shannon a call at 902-4181 to tailor your security.
Colts will be kicking off. 10 minutes to go in the second quarter. Colts lead 20-0. Game kind of going as expected, Franklin. Delta Streets, how long have they been?
I don't think they've been playing football very long, have they, Bobby?
I'd have to look see when they were founded. Charter school down there in Greenwood. So, you know, impressive job on just getting a program off the ground.
Yeah, no doubt.
From
scratch. They appear to be well coached. Just a little out talented.
That's a good booming kick. Caught it to 10-yard line. They're going to come up the right side. Antisa's there. Misses the tackle. And let's see who gets him down. That's Moser. Sawyer in there.
Yeah, he's
going to well.
He's going to get out to the 40, but we got a flag on the play. That's probably going to push the streets back, push the lines back here a little bit to start.
That's a little tricky for you,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, you know, I'm stuck on the streets. It just sounds better. It rolls off better than the lines.
You know what I think about when I hear the streets?
The streets. I got street cred, Bobby.
I know the song Regulator.
Yeah.
On the street, got to earn your keep.
Yeah. Well, the defense is actually doing that tonight. They're earning their keep tonight. They're getting in there. They're pursuing the ball really well. They got lots of Colts around every ball carrier. So good job recovering tonight by the Colts defense. Let's see if they can continue it.
Thank you. That one's probably pretty easy. All right, Colts line up. Overload to the left. Their handoff up the gut. Spinks. Looks like Artis.
That's number 22, Daniel Crane on the carry for the line.
And Ethan Payton there. No, it's Bram Harris in there as well.
Number 54, Reese Spinks.
Yeah, good job by the front line of the Colts there. They're clocking that thing up. They only get about 2 yards there for the Lions.
Be second and eight for the Lions.
Second and eight. They come out of a three-receiver set. Snaps away. Toss pass there, and they're holding our end there. But we're going to still get them behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, we're going to get him way back there. The good pursuit by the Colts again. They got a lot of guys up the field. But there's going to be a flag on the play. Probably something you might want to decline here, Bobby.
Yeah, you might. I mean, we got – you can either have second and 18 or we can have third and nine or eight.
Yeah, they're going to move them back.
Holding the line.
No. We just said.
Well, he said decline, but they already moved him back, so I'm not sure if they communicated very well on that.
Oh, yeah, my goodness.
We're going to have to bring the ball back. Yeah, the Colts declined that penalty, so it's going to be third and eight, third and nine.
Yeah, I hope they remember where they were because even the down marker left. So that looks to be about right. Third and 11.
Yeah, it looked like they got him about a two-yard loss there, so –
All right, Colts looking to protect against the pass. A rollout. Throws it there. And we miss the tackle. And Walker has to get him from behind. Who's out there in coverage? Is that Antisi and Mosier there? Had two guys there to make the tackle, and we just missed
it. Yeah, well, they hadn't been throwing it all night, so we kind of fell asleep there on the pass. He makes an easy completion there, and we miss a tackle to get him down as he's going to pick up the first down for the Lions.
First and 10. We got 8:55 to go. All right. They'll run underneath. And they're gutting us up the middle. And that's about a 15-yard scamper.
Yeah, we got pushed around up front that time, and he finds a hole and he hits it hard. He got a little speed there, so he's going to pick up another first down for the Lions.
Snaps back. Looking, Harris is trying to get in there, disrupts the play, and the cavalry comes. I think that was Artis and Dixon getting in there.
Yeah, good job by Bram Harris. He gets in the backfield really early to slow that thing down. The rest of his teammates come to clean that up for a loss on the play. That's going to bring up second long for the Lions.
8:10 to go in the second quarter. Colts lead 20 to nothing. I've seen a little bit more fight, but the missed tackles from last week
still a little disturbing.
Again.
Yep.
We try to get off the edge, and now we bottle them up. Is that Artis?
Yeah, we send Artis straight up the middle, and he just had a beeline of the quarterback, and he brings him down.
Well, Artis has dropped down in kind of a nose guard position, and he's giving them fits. A lot of quickness there up front, tough for the center to handle.
Yeah, there was nobody there to block him, and he just plows through the middle of that offensive line, and he gets the quarterback quick. Good job by Artis there, getting there and making the tackle.
Burton appears to have an equipment issue, and we send out Warner Lively to fill in for the linebacker's position. We got third and about 20. Snaps away. They're just going to run the quarterback keep this way. Williams is there. Gets him pushed out of bounds. It'll bring up fourth and 13.
Yeah, he had a little room on the outside there, but the Colts came over and was able to push him out of bounds before he picks up much. It's going to bring a fourth and long here, about fourth and 12.
It looks like they may send out the punting unit. 55, the punter, I think he is.
Yeah, not a bad punt the first time they punted it. Let's see if they can Colts can corral this one and get a little return here.
Back deep is
We'll send number 10, Mosier, back deep. Spinks get a little pressure. Ball's going to check up and fall. Colts will have it first and 10 from the 32-yard line.
And not a bad punt, not a bad punt by the Lions there, but a friendly bounce for the Colts as it bounces the other way. So the Colts going to have good field position to start about their own 31-yard line.
First and 10. All right, we'll come out in the two receiver set, pro style backfield. Strong right formation. Snaps away. We're going to look. And Mosier is wide open.
And he goes the other way. He's looking for Tanner.
On
the sideline. They're both kind of open, but he misses Mosier early. He was wide open coming out of the.
Yeah, maybe we need to put one of those sirens on Mosier, because it's like a blinking light.
so he can see him.
Man,
he can
wide
find
open.
It. Yeah, he was there wide open early, too.
There
he had 10 yards on him.
There was nobody in the frame with him. So
Tanner breaks away late, and so neither pass it was terrible, but, yeah, he had Mosier early there.
We come in the two receiver set again. Mosier is your outside, Favy inside. Snaps away. We're going to look again. And now we're going to hit Mosier. And he makes the catch.
Yeah,
great catch.
Yeah, great catch by 10 there in traffic. Good throw by William Walker. He hits him right in the numbers, and Will's able to bring that thing down. That's going to be a first down for the Colts.
Yeah, Walker grabbing his wrist. I couldn't see what happened.
Did
we'll take
hit?
A quick timeout.
He might have hit a helmet on the throw there.
Alec Bird, proud former Lee Academy football player and current agent at Delta Insurance Agency. Whether it's homeowners, auto, farm, commercial, life, or crop insurance, the experienced agents at Delta Insurance are here to guide you through your decision-making process to give you the peace of mind that your family and assets are protected. Give Alan Bird, Drew Brown, or myself a call at 662-483-1633.
Like Walker.
Since 1980, Dunn Crop Insurance has been the premier provider of crop insurance in the Mississippi Delta. For revenue, wind and hail, or replant protection, give Mason Dunn or John Andrew Augustinelli a call at 662-649-8300 or visit them at 320 West Lee Drive, Clarksdale, Mississippi.
Thank you, Kevin. All right, Walker's going to get checked out on the sideline. We'll bring in Braden Antisha to fill in at the quarterback position. Mosier in motion. Snaps away. We hand off left side. And he hits a seam. Williams finds Blockins. Rides him down, gets inside the 30, down to the 25-yard line.
That was a great job of the offensive line, Bobby. I don't know who that was out in front of him, but he did a great job blocking. Williams just follows him, let him set the blocks, and then he cuts it out outside. And really good job there by everybody involved between the blocker and Williams there, picking up the big yardage for the Colts.
Well, you know, Williams is a patient runner. Sometimes that works against him. But you had trying to see who you had out there. I think that was Peyton and maybe Squirrel out there. Snaps, handoff underneath, and going to find enough running room to pick up 2 or 3 yards.
And William Walker's back out there at quarterback, so he appears to be okay.
Yeah, I don't know if hit a finger, but best I could tell, maybe hit a helmet. Colts lead 20-0, 5:45 to go in the first quarter. We've got second and 6. We'll send Fava to the top. Mosier's your H-back. Snaps away. We're going to give to Tillis. Tillis darts inside and picks up good yardage, but we had the tackle kicking out there and just loses his block.
Yeah.
Got to stay with that block and he gets a little more yardage.
Yeah, he kicked out. He had the guy in his sights. He just missed him. And Tillis hit the hole good, but the guy came free and a good tackle there by the Lions defender to bring Tillis down short of the line of game.
I mean, the tackle was there. The tackle was on him. It just didn't keep the block. Third and short. All right, and we make him jump offside. That gives us a free 5 yards and a free first down. They'll have it first and 10, probably on the 13-yard line. Maybe a little closer.
Yeah, easy first down by the Colts there by a penalty, so that's going to set them up in good position here.
The referees are having some discussion now, so. Delta Street's looking guilty, already backed up.
Yeah. I don't know if maybe they're talking about did the center move the ball and that's why the defensive line jumped, but we'll find out after the conference here. Of course, we can't see from here if the center moved it.
And they got encroachment on the defense. So, free first down. Colts will have it first and 10.
First and 10, Lee Academy.
On the 13-yard line. Well, you know, I know we ran that earlier, that little out pass. I mean, it'd be open again.
Yeah, it's there, and then you get Redwine across the middle. He'll probably be open here again, too.
Yeah, we'll send Favor down to the bottom. Mosier in motion. Snaps away. We're going to go with the crossbuck until Tillis gets through, and he makes it to the end zone. At that time, we got
the block. Yeah, they sustained the block and opened it wide open for Tillis. He used his speed on the outside. Great job by the blocking on the offensive line. Good job by Tillis to hit it hard, use his speed, get in the end zone.
It's good to see Sandy getting some action. Dealt with a little bit of sickness over the last couple games, but, first game against Pilla, I mean, he was.
Yeah, he played a good game. Absolutely.
He had 82 yards and kick is up. Kick is no good.
That's going to be wide right.
Colts lead 26-0. 4:43 to go. We'll catch a quick break.
The Academy Colts are proudly supported by Triple M Crop Services. Local and family-owned Triple M has provided sound service to its customers for over 25 years. Stop by and see Chris or Thornton Marley at 560 Friars Point Road in Clarksdale. Or give Chris a ring at 662-902-4297 or Thornton at 662-902-51. Security and Satellite is a proud sponsor of the Lee Academy Colts. Since 1999, Shannon Dixon has been providing all of your alarm, camera, and home audio system needs. Give Shannon a call at 902-4181 to tailor your security needs.
Yeah.
You by Sumter Bath, and Bull Riles of Pfizer Insurance.
4:43. Colts will be kicking off. Right, kind of a squid hip, and they fall on it.
Street. That's a novel idea, just fall on that little kick that comes short.
I mean, they'll have it first and 10. It's probably the best starting for, other than that long kickoff.
Well, I'm just, we haven't seen that much from the Colts when somebody kicks it short to us. We have not been very good with that type of kick.
Yeah, we've left a few on the turf for the other team. All right, 4:41. We need another stop.
Yeah, you just want to see continued pressure, continued pursuit. A lot of green shirts around the football. They've been doing that all night. They know they're probably more talented, but you still want to make sure that you see it all night long. Want to see the effort.
Right, they'll send two receivers out, overload to the right. Snaps away, and they'll run cutback. Mosier tries to get there, and then we don't stop him. And he breaks away. Williams trying to chase him down. And we miss him again. And a great run by number 22. And
Like we just mentioned, the arm tackling, not doing the things that you, we had him wrapped up three times and can't bring him down.
Yeah, the missed tackle woes of last week showed up again.
Yes, they did.
But I commend Delta Street's running back, a really hard run.
He hit the hole hard and kept going. Yeah, good job.
They'll have it first and 10 on the Colt 13-yard line. Snaps away, and he cuts back, tries to find a lane, and we've got a flag in the area of holding.
Yeah, much better by the Colts defensive line there. At the point of attack, they made contact, and they got him down early. No more arm tackling. Bodied him up, brought him down, short game.
Number 22, Brown Harris.
A lot of Brown Harris fans out there, Bobby.
Yeah.
Good crowd.
Face mask again for the Academy.
Face mask given 5 yards. I think we'll replay the down, so they'll have first and 5 from about the 9-yard line. And the Lions will take a timeout. We'll pause in action to catch a quick break.
When choosing a bank, wouldn't you prefer to deal with a local institution with years of loyal service to the community that it serves? That's precisely what you get with First National Bank of Clarksdale, Bank of Oxford. With over 50 years of service, our friendly staff has been providing the Clarksdale and Oxford areas reliable support with checking accounts, savings and loan opportunities, CDs, IRAs, and much, much more. With 3 easy and convenient locations in Clarksdale and 2 in Oxford, it's never been easier to be your hometown bank. First National Bank of Clarksdale, Bank of Oxford, member FDIC. Go Colts!
The Beastie Boys.
Security and Satellite is a proud sponsor of the Lee Academy Colts. Since 1999, Shannon Dixon has been providing all of your alarm, camera, and home audio system needs. Give Shannon a call at 902-418.
First and 5 for the Lions. There's somebody in motion. And they'll run underneath, and we're trying to get contained. Williams makes a good hit. And Bram Harris drags him down. Another flag on the field, though.
Yeah, he got bottled up in the middle where he was trying to go, and he jumps it outside, but good pursuit by the Colts. But once again, we got some more laundry on the field.
Yeah, I think that one's going to be holding. That'll back him up 10 yards from the spot. So they have the ball out over to the 21-yard line. Where they got to get? To the 4?
Yeah, I do believe so, Bobby.
It's about 17 yards to get to the line to gain.
But still first down.
Yeah, this is the deepest they've got in the Colt territory.
Been a slow second quarter. We still got 4 minutes to go in this quarter.
Now they reposition the ball, and now it's on the
– Now we're on the 18.
18. Snapped away, looking. And incomplete pass. Kind of fumbled the ball. Williams made a hit, but –
That play was open, though, Bobby. He makes a better throw, and that guy's able to – catch it. He's got some room there. Good job by Williams being there, getting to knock it out.
Yeah, the quarterback hadn't shown a lot of accuracy or a lot of ability for a deep threat. So Tillis and Williams are your corners. Safety is Mosier. And we got the rest of the guys on the line of scrimmage. And they'll cut back and get through the line of scrimmage. And we're going to drag him down about the 10-yard line.
Yeah, we had it loaded up for up front, but good job by the Lions offensive line pushing us off the ball, creating a hole there. Good run by the Lions. They're gonna be third down in about five or six here.
Well, I mean, we've got everybody on the line. Both linebackers have walked up. Outside linebackers have walked up.
We just got blown off the line there. Just got beat.
Well, I mean, all it takes is one crease there and he gets through. With no support at the second level other than Mosier, who's deep.
Big third down here for the Colts. See if they can, probably two down territory.
That's the way. Handoff. He tries to go up the middle again. Fighting for good yardage and going to get down to the 8-yard line. That's still going to be about 4 yards short of the first down.
Yeah, much better by the Colts there. Good pursuit. Reese is in there. Peyton Burton was in there. He was around the ball. Good job getting him down at the point of contact. That's going to bring up fourth down for the Lions. See if the Colts can bow their back here. Get the ball back.
Yeah, I would say be ready for a pass, but they've been quick to run in this down and distance. They'll send two receivers to the top. We'll shift over. And they'll call a timeout. We'll catch a quick break. Colts will be looking to stop a fourth down when we return.
The Academy Colts are proudly supported by Triple M Crop Services. Local and family-owned Triple M has provided sound service to its customers for over 25 years. Stop by and see Chris or Thornton Marley at 560 Friars Point Road in Clarksdale, or give Chris a ring at 662-902-4297.
All right, a big play, second quarter action, 2:23 to go.
Yeah, let's see if the Colts can continue to build some defensive confidence here so they can get the stop, turn the ball over here and get the ball back.
Motion. Snaps away, looking to pass. And he oh, my goodness. They get the ball through about three hands for the Colts.
Just a busted play there. Good job by the quarterback getting it out. It goes over two Colts, and it just finds its way to a Lions receiver, and he's in for the touchdown.
Now, I mean, it's tough trying to maybe make a play there to get an interception, but
yeah,
it's four just down, just bat it down.
Yeah, it's just a completely busted play. They go for the interception and gets right over their hands, and he's in for the score.
Yeah, I mean they were in position. Snap it back, kick is up. The kick appears to be good. Lions close the gap, but Colts still lead 26-7. We'll catch a quick break.
Since 1980, Dunn Crop Insurance has been the premier provider of crop insurance in the Mississippi Delta. For revenue, wind and hail, or replant protection, give Mason Dunn or John Andrew Augustinelli a call at 662-649-8300 or visit them at 320 West Lee Drive, Clarksdale, Mississippi. Security and Satellite is a proud sponsor of the Lee Academy Colts. Since 1999, Shannon Dixon has been providing all of your alarm, camera, and home audio system needs. Give Shannon a call at 902-4181 to tailor your security.
Right, we got plenty of time on the clock, Franklin. 2:15.
Yeah, you'd like to see them just take the ball down the field and see if they can just eat this clock up and get a late score here before the half, and we get the ball to start the third quarter. So go a little 2-for-1 action here for the Colts. Opportunity, anyway.
Yeah. Now we need a good run back here. We got Artis and Williams back deep.
Well, deep's a relative term there, Bobby.
Yeah, yeah, a little shallow.
We're at the 30.
And they kick. It's like a pooch kick. We let it go. Get on the ball.
I don't understand why we continue to play that pooch kick like we do. Somebody needs to go get it. We're letting it roll. We're not pursuing it. We're not going to get it. The up guy's letting it go. The back's not coming up to get it. They're going to have to get that figured out.
Well, Artis was a little closer than us, so you know, maybe it was obvious to him it was
going
out.
Maybe so.
Yeah, we've just seen too many knives.
We've seen so many. Yeah, that's right. A little gun shy there on those kicks. I would have been a little closer to him. Push it out of bounds.
Yeah. I, as the kids say, a little sus.
A little sus.
Colts will have it 1st and 10. Ball on the line's 42-yard line. We got Fava to the bottom. Strong right formation. Motion. Snaps away. We're going to look. All right, take it off. Take it. All right. Now Fava's there, and he misses it. Great scramble. Great pass. Just a little high.
Yeah, good job by Walker there getting out of trouble. He finds Fava wide open with the pass. So just a little high. Good effort on Fava to try to go up and get it, but it falls incomplete. Again, great job by Walker getting out of the trouble and finding its receiver downfield.
Yeah. All right, we get Fava to the bottom. Strong right formation. Snaps back. Looking. And we throw it over the middle. And now Fava catches it. And he gets the ball inside the 30 down to the 23-yard line. Great catch.
Yeah, great throw by Walker there. He puts it right on him. And good job by Fava going up there and high-pointing that football, bringing it in with his hands. That's what we're more accustomed to by seeing Fava right there. Good job on the catch.
First and 10. We've got 1:55 to go.
Yeah, the Colts are moving quick here.
Two receiver set. Snaps back. Now we're looking. We hit the pop pass. Moser's trying to get a block, and he does. We got and he hurdles over a guy, and he gets into the end zone.
Yeah, great little play there. Good job by Moser blocking downfield. Tanner.
Yeah, we got a flag down
back here. A good run by Fava after the catch. He hurdles a guy. He makes a little hop step to his left. And
when we got blockers out there, the tackle – Maslin got out there and laid a good block, but that may have got Moser early.
Hold it, Lee Academy.
Yeah, going to get a hold on the play. That's going to back him up. Well, they're coming out slinging on this drive, Bobby, here late in the second quarter.
Well, you need to work on a little bit of a two-minute offense and try to push the ball up the field. Snaps away, looking. We fake it. And Walker's going to break loose. He's going to get to the 20, to the 10, 5, touchdown.
Yeah, he was looking for Will Moser early, and Will was covered, and he couldn't get there. And then William does a great job of scrambling, find the open side on the left-hand side, and he takes it in for the score for the Colts.
That's just all effort by number 7.
Yeah, good job recognizing that throw wasn't there. He eats it, and then he finds his way out of there. Good job by the senior quarterback.
Well, with them committing so many to the box, Franklin, it's tough for the line to block them all.
Yeah, so, no, yeah, he did a great –
All right, we're going to go for 2 here. Williams, Artis in the backfield. Snaps away, looking for the pass. Williams is there, and takes a hit, and then he works upfield for the two-point conversion.
Yeah, great job by Williams there, absorbing the hit and then staying on his feet and getting in for the two-point conversion.
Well, on that last play, great scramble by Walker, but it's a long developing play.
No, well, what I liked most about that was he understood that Will Mosier was not open there. He didn't force it in.
I agree with that.
He brings it in just to live another day, and then, you know, with his athleticism, he gets around the outside and gets the score.
Yeah.
I just wanted, you know, good job by him recognizing it wasn't there and moving on to the next play.
118 to go in the half. Colts will be kicking off. Yeah, we'll get the ball coming out of the second half. Well, now they'll probably try to run their two-minute offense. And maybe we'll put together our two-minute defense. Favorite doing the kicking duties. We got out there, we got Artis, Antisi, Mosier, Dixon, Diaz, Spinks, Peyton, Harris, Walker, and Williams. Squib kick, gonna bounce, and they're gonna fall on at the 30-yard line. Lions will have it first and 10 from their own 30.
Yeah, great job by the Colts there getting the score, knowing they'll get the ball and start the third quarter. Again, another fifth quarter at the church tonight. Bobby and I will not be calling the fifth quarter, if you're wondering. We will not be there.
I had to call one last night. Congratulations to the junior varsity Colts. Good win at North Delta Greenway, 50-22.
Big win.
Well, Monix played the whole. They set up a screen. Walker's there and almost intercepts it.
That would have been a pick six there if Walker could have corralled that one. Good job on the recognition.
You know, Monix played all four quarters last night.
So we won't see any of Monix tonight.
He'll come out. He'll come out in the second half.
Oh, he can play the second half.
Yeah,
okay.
He can play six quarters.
Yeah, I saw Big Desi on the sideline early tonight. Talk to him.
Second and 10 for the Lions. They come up in a three-receiver set. Snaps away, looking for pass. And they get a little pick play. You know, the outside receiver started blocking the corner before the ball was there.
Yeah, he did. You could see that early.
So that'll be defensive pass interference. Oh, you made it. Ounce that? I guess you maybe want to film it. Sonic Drive-In will be sponsoring a chance to win a $100 gift card if one of our youngsters can kick it through the uprights.
Does he get a jersey and get to play next week if he kicks it?
Well, it depends on the on how good he kicks it.
You know, I've seen that happen before in college. Kid went out there, kicked it for a competition, and next thing you know, he's suited up for a college football team. No, it doesn't.
Snaps away. They're just going to hand off underneath, and Artis is going to eat him up.
Yeah, great job by the Colts there, getting upfield and getting him down early.
Burton and Walker in there to help, too. I think Colt's going to get a timeout here. 54 seconds to go. We're going to take a quick commercial break.
It's 1980 Dunn Crop Insurance has been the premier provider of crop insurance in the Mississippi Delta. For revenue, wind and hail, or replant protection, give Mason Dunn or John Andrew Augustinelli a call at 662-649-8300 or visit them at 320 West Lee Drive, Clarksdale, Mississippi.
Shorter.
Security and Satellite is a proud sponsor of the Lee Academy Colts. Since 1999, Shannon Dixon has been providing all of your alarm, camera, and home audio system needs. Give Shannon a call at 902-4181 to tailor your security.
It's third and 27 for the Lions. We're going to keep the same front. They come out in a three receiver set. Snaps away. A quarterback draw and doesn't go anywhere. That Otter's in there again. I think Peyton was there. I think Peyton and Otter's in on the tackle. Artists from the nose guard position have really given them fits tonight.
Brought down by number 7, William Walker, and 59, Frank Peyton. A do-over, Ethan Peyton.
I guess we call timeout. We'll catch another break.
The Academy Colts are proudly supported by Triple M Crop Services. Local and family-owned, Triple M has provided sound service to its customers for over 25 years. Stop by and see Chris or Thornton Marley at 560 Friars Point Road in Clarksdale, or give Chris a ring at 662-902-4297 or Thornton at 662-902-5145.
Hey, fourth and 27. Lions will punt. 50 seconds left on the clock, so we got time for another score, Franklin.
Well,
snaps away, kick is up. It's going to get a pretty decent roll, and it's going to come to rest on the 45-yard line, but it's in Lions territory. Colts will have it first and 10.
Yeah, as quick as they move the ball downfield on the last drive, you think from here inside Lions territory to start, they got a chance to put some more points on the board.
Yeah, we started at what, about the 35 last time, and we had a minute 50 left, so. First and 10, Mosier in motion. He's looking, he's going into a route and fighting for his life, and he gets thrown down in the backfield.
Yeah, Walker couldn't get away for that time from big number 62 for the Lions. He's going to take him down for a sack.
Well, longer developing plays put more pressure on your line to hold up, and we didn't hold up at all there. So
no, and he got in there quick, and this time Walker wasn't able to get away from him.
All right, out of timeouts, we got 10 seconds to go. Snatched away. Looking. Mosier's open. He's going to come back to it. He's going to catch it. He's going to be down the sideline, but he's going to be dragged down at the 25, and that horn will sound.
Yeah, good job by Walker, waiting, finding this open guy. Good catch by Mosier. Again, he's having a good night.
Well, we'll be back in 15 minutes with a halftime break.
$100 gift certificate to Sonic. Today's pick is Bo Luster. Mr. Luster, please go down to the field. Gotta get suited up. Let's go, Bo. Bo Luster is a ninth grade student at Lee Academy. He is currently the starting center for the junior high football team. So we're expecting big things out of Bo as they are an undefeated football squad. All right, student section, can we get some chants? Can we get Bo, Bo, Bo? Okay, here goes Bo as he gets ready for his first attempt. Oh, we have our first attempt was not successful, but we know that he'll give it another good try. Let's go, Bo. One more try. Here we go, second attempt. Oh, so close. Good try, Bo. Thanks for being a good sport. Everybody come back next week. We'll have another field goal attempt. Well, not next week. We have homecoming. The week after. All right, we want to announce our Colt Fans of the Week. Our Kid Colt Fans of the Week this week, we have Maddox Flowers and Stone NTC. Congratulations, thank y'all for being Colt Fans. And our Colt Fan of the Week is a very great, wonderful Lee Academy supporter. He's fondly known as
All right, all right, all right. We got about a minute and a half to go.
0-1. They moved in 0-1.
All right, Colts get the kickoff coming out of the halftime break. Looks like we've had some part the live stream for halftime.
Yeah, Bobby, after that first half scores, looks like some of them took off.
Yeah, well, you know.
And I hate that because I meant to give a shout-out early. I talked to some fans on the way in tonight, and they said we got some people watching from Florida.
Yeah, yeah.
Got some fans watching from Florida. So shout-out to our Florida fans for tuning in and watching the Colts.
Are you going to do the trivia after the third quarter?
After the third quarter, yeah. Between the third and the fourth quarter, we'll have our South Group trivia tonight.
All right, Colts come up hands team tight formation. We'll watch the pooch kick. Kick is away. We pooch it and we fall on it.
All right, good job there by Mr. Antisi, falling on it, setting the Colts up, good field position.
Yeah, first and 10, ball on the 37-yard line.
We got, static in there.
Yeah, I may need to get a new board. I think I got another one at the house. It's a little bigger. First and 10, Spinks leads the big guys up to the line. Pretty good job by the offensive group. A little suspect on a few passes, but overall good job. Snaps away. We give it up to Gutt, and that's Artis. And he's going to get in the open, and he's going to break away to the 30, 20, 10, 5, touchdown.
Yeah, good run, hard run by Artis there. He shook a couple of arm tackles and takes it to the house. Good job by the offense, giving him a little crease. He hits it again. Shakes a couple of tackles. He's in for 6.
Well, good blocking up front. Coming out of halftime down 34-7, that wasn't the same effort we saw.
No,
in the first
not
half.
A lot of energy from the Lions there.
Colts would go for the extra point. Snaps back. Kick is up. Kick is good. Colts lead 41-7. We'll take a quick break.
Since 1980, Dunn Crop Insurance has been the premier provider of crop insurance in the Mississippi Delta. For revenue, wind and hail, or replant protection, give Mason Dunn or John Andrew Augustinelli a call at 662-Security and Satellite is a proud sponsor of the Lee Academy Colts. Since 1999, Shannon Dixon has been providing all of your alarm, camera, and home audio system needs. Give Shannon a call at 902-4181 to tailor your security needs.
All right, Colts will be kicking off. Favor doing your kicking duties. He's been doing a good job getting it down near the 20. Good bounce. Pin him a little deeper. And we'll squib it down. And they fielded it on the knee. So
yeah, he must have had a knee down there, Bobby. I didn't see it completely, but I'm gathering there was a knee on the ground.
Yeah, I think they're
going to
have
that.
It first and 10 at the 29-yard line.
All right, let's see if the Colts can continue the pressure they've had on defense all night. See if the energy's still up after halftime.
They'll break huddle, send two receivers out. They got the overload left. Snaps away. They come that way. And we bottle them up. I think that's Maslin kind of catching from behind. Peyton was there as well.
Yeah, good job by the defensive front there. They put pressure on him, leaned on the offensive line there, and he had nowhere to go. They got him down early.
Second and nine for the Lions. They're looking to pass, and they throw it over the middle, and we just whiff. And Harris is going to try to get him down, and he's going to take it to the house.
Yeah, nice little pitch and catch there, and he works through two arm tackles. He's going to get the score for the Lions.
41-13, we'll await the try.
Yeah, they only had two defenders back. They both got arms on him, but once he got through both of them, there was nobody there, and he takes it to the house for six.
Looks like they'll line up for the extra point. Snaps back. Kick is up. Kick is good. But they're going to blow it dead for some reason.
We got a flag in the backfield.
I'm not sure what the flag is. Yeah. I don't see, but there's a guy. That may be the 12th guy. They still got 12 out there. So you got to take one off.
How many men on the field for the Lions? How many
yards? I'm not sure. I don't know if that's five or what.
Okay, it must just be five. I thought it was more than that. He don't have a. He kind of barely makes it out. They still got.
I think now they got 11, maybe. Snaps away. Kick is up. Good kick. Kick's good. 41-14. We'll catch a quick break.
It's 1980. Dunn Crop Insurance has been the premier provider of crop insurance in the Mississippi Delta. For revenue, wind and hail, or replant protection, give Mason Dunn or John Andrew Augustinelli a call at 662-649-8300 or visit them at 320 West Lee Drive, Clarksdale, Mississippi.
Mississippi Land Bank has been rooted in relationships in North Mississippi for decades. We know agriculture because we live it every day by helping young farmers get started.
My grandfather farmed, my dad farmed, just felt like that's what God called me to do. They got a lot of knowledge about land and what stuff's worth and what it's not worth, kind of give you some guidance and wisdom on maybe what to do and not do.
Mississippi Land Bank, advocates for agriculture rooted in relationships.
Scores from around the area. Bio Academy leads Pillow Academy 27-7. Washington School leads Riverfield Academy 20-7. And hey, Boone's won. I'm out. I haven't been doing that the whole time. Artis will get back there, and he'll pick it up, and he's going to bring it out, and he's going to try to find a lane, and he does. He's down the sideline. One guy to beat, and he gets past the kicker to the 20. 10-5 touchdown.
Incredible effort by Artis there. He had to run 20 yards back to get the long kick.
I don't think
he breaks one tackle and he was untouched the rest of the way.
I don't think you can count that, but if you go back 20 and then you run 90,
yeah, that's
110 yards you had to run.
That's a long run. Great job on the return there.
They got to go And Colts will go to two. If we stretch this to 35, the clock will start to run. So 10:35 to go in the third quarter. And Colts are going to go for two. Looking for a pass. Quick slant route to Fava. 2-point try is good. 49-14. Colts lead. We'll catch a quick break.
The roads we take in life don't just take us someplace physically, but also spiritually. And the best roads we take aren't paved, but dirt or gravel. When we leave the pavement, we leave the outside world behind. We tend to focus on what really matters, our families, our friendships, and the land and wildlife we share with those people. At Mossy Oak Properties, we get that, which is why when you need the road to lead to your favorite place, we're your land specialists. Mossy Oak Properties. Find your favorite place.
Colts have made the best of their opportunities on offense.
Yeah, good job on the two-point conversion there, and after the great run by Artis to get in the end zone on the kickoff.
Fave will be kicking off. The clock is running. If you want to do the trivia, you might want to just go ahead and do it.
Just do it while we got 59 people still watching.
Well, the fourth quarter is going to be really short.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll let this kickoff go, and then we'll get into the trivia.
They've had a couple successful kickoff returns, so we need to find a soft spot. Squib kicks work fairly well. All right, that ball's going to roll, going to be picked up, fielded. He's going to go backwards. Sawyer's trying to get down there. And, I mean, that is a – we're going to have back-to-back kick return. You know, that Pennington got a crackback block down here.
Yeah, he got hit pretty hard there. I'm not sure the hit was legal.
No, he gets taken down pretty good. But good return by Delta Streets. They'll have the ball first and 10 from their own 47-yard line.
Yeah, so we'll bring to you now the South Group trivia for tonight. South Group, 118 3rd Street, Clarksville, Mississippi, 662-624-6571. Call, speak to an agent for all your personal and commercial needs. So the trivia question for tonight is, who was the very first homecoming queen for Lee Academy?
That's tough.
We got homecoming coming up next week, so we thought we'd do a little homecoming trivia tonight.
Snaps away. They're going to run off left side. Walker's going to be there to try to bring him down, and he's fighting. A lot of fight left there.
Yeah, good job by Walker holding on to him to keep him from getting any more yardage. That kid was really moving the legs there.
Yeah, I think it was last year, Franklin, that they brought several of the homecoming queens back. And
I think it was 2 or 3 years ago because I was here. And Yeah, they paraded them all out here. And they did it again last year, too.
Yeah, they did it last year.
Okay. No, that's right. It was last year. You're right. Absolutely.
7 minutes to go. Lines a break huddle with a 2nd and 7. Colts are getting some younger guys on the field. I see Humber in there. Monix in there. Snaps away. Quarterback keep. Peyton's there. Harris is there.
Yeah, great job by Peyton and Harris there. Sandwich tackling there in the backfield. You also had
Maslin in there.
74.
Well.
Yeah, good job.
All right, so young guys, you got Humber. You got Curtis. Let's see. You got Redwine in there at defensive end. Yeah. third and nine for the Lions. That's the way. Counter action this way. Humber's there. Red line holds a pickup of about four on the play. Bring up fourth and four.
Yeah, good job by some of the younger guys in there getting him down early. Going to bring up a fourth down for the Lions.
Number 11, Darius Curtis.
The clock's running, and now we're going to have a water break. We'll catch a quick ad.
The Academy Colts are proudly supported by Triple M Crop Services. Local and family-owned, Triple M has provided sound service to its customers for over 25 years. Stop by and see Chris or Thornton Marley at 560 Friars Point Road in Clarksdale, or give Chris a ring at 662-902-4297, or Thornton at 662-902-51. Security and Satellite is a proud sponsor of the Lee Academy Colts. Since 1999, Shannon Dixon has been providing all of your alarm, camera, and home audio system needs. Give Shannon a call at 902-4181 to tailor your security needs.
We'll come out of the water timeout. 5:38 to go in the third quarter. Colts lead 49-14. Lions staring down at fourth and six for the line to gain. They'll have to get it out to the 42-yard line of the Colts to continue this drive. They'll send two receivers out. H back to the right. Shotgun formation snaps away. They're just going to hand off, and he's not going to get there.
Hey, it looks like he's going to come up just a little short to where they got him marked down. Good job by the Colts defense to get him stopped.
That is a yeah, okay. That's a great spot, but I think they're going to come up short. First down, Colts.
Let's see if we see your little backup quarterback action here.
Yeah, we're going to get some younger guys on offense as well. I see Pennington out there, Harris, Humber, let's see who else. Yeah, some confusion out there. We don't have a fullback. So,
yeah, a little unhappiness by the coach there, so he gets a timeout to get them reset on offense.
All right, we'll catch a quick break here.
The roads we take in life don't just take us someplace physically, but also spiritually. And the best roads we take aren't paved, but dirt or gravel. When we leave the pavement, we leave the outside world behind. We tend to focus on what really matters, our families, our friendships, and the land and wildlife we share with those people. At Mossy Oak Properties, we get that, which is why when you need the road to lead to your favorite place, we're your land specialists. Mossy Oak Properties. Find your favorite place.
All right, Colts get Burton out there, fullback. Snaps away. And we give to Burton up the gut. And he makes a good 10-yard run, first and 10 Colts.
Yeah, good strong run by Burton there. You know, he's been playing linebacker all night, doing a great job on defense. Like to see him get rewarded with a carry there.
Yeah.
And TC will bring the Colts to the line.
At first down, we got Tillis and Burton in the backfield. Snaps away. We're going to give to Burton off the left side, and they bottle him up this time.
Yeah, you know, Bobby, I was going to mention this earlier. You know, the Delta Street Lions are working with about, maybe if I counted right, about 18 players.
Yeah.
So I do want to applaud the way that they've played all night tonight. Yeah, you know they've got to be tired, got to be worn out.
Yeah, it was a great initial effort. Snaps away. And we're just going to give it another dive into Burton up the middle. And no gain on the play.
Yeah, nothing doing for the Colts there. It goes go back to the same play, and they bottled it up again. It's going to bring up third and long for the Colts.
And we got a young arm in there with Antici. Let's see what he can do. We'll send Humber out to the top. Harris is your eight back in motion. Snaps away, and we fumble the ball.
Fumble on the play.
Looks like the Lions are going to pounce on it, and they're going to get the ball back here at midfield.
Yeah, you know.
Recovered by the Lions.
Quarterback appeared to just get out from under the center a little too quick. Fumble that ball. It's a minute and a half to go in the third quarter. Clock is rolling.
During our varsity or junior varsity games, please contact the school.
You know, even late in the game like this, Bobby, in a lead like that, you still want to see good execution.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's going to be a lot of next year's guys out there, so. First and 10 Lions. Snaps back. Looking to pass. And he's going to sail it through. We had, I think, Tillis and Antici in coverage.
Yeah, Sandy was looking for the interception there, and he comes in, and I think him and Antici bump into each other, so they weren't able to come down with it. But good job on the coverage.
Clock under 30 seconds. Time for one play. Snaps back. Just a wildcat to the right. He finds room. He's going to break through the line, cut back, and that may be the end of his uniform.
Yeah, they got nothing but jersey there, but they were able to get him down, Bobby. But after he picks up a big gain off of the right side there for the Lions.
Number four lost his right sleeve the first play of the game when Walker threw him down. I think he lost the other half of his jersey there.
Yeah, he may not have. They're going to have to get him a new jersey before the next game.
All right, we'll take a quick break.
The Academy Colts are proudly supported by Triple M Crop Services. Local and family-owned Triple M has provided sound service to its customers for over 25 years. Stop by and see Chris or Thornton Marley at 560 Friars Point Road in Clarksdale, or give Chris a ring at 662-902-4297 or Thornton at 662-902-514.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the trivia question is still available. In honor of next year's homecoming.
Next week's
homecoming. The question is, who was the first Lee Academy homecoming queen?
1971.
Now, you know, we battled a lot of illnesses with the team. I think we finally got everybody well and healthy. Jennings will probably be back next week, and that'll be as healthy as we can get. Give a shout-out to Jordan Blair. I think he's been at home with the bug as well, couldn't attend tonight. Hope he's better for next week. We'll have North Delta coming to town for the homecoming game. Snaps away, handoff to 22 off the left side. And Artis was chasing him down. I'm not sure who ended up making the tackle.
Looks like there was a fumble on the play, Bobby. I think the Colts may have come up with it.
Yeah, like Artis may have got in from behind and punched it out. The Colts covered up. Colts have it first and 10.
Good job by the defense. Good to see them still pursuing. Big effort out there, even though we're in the fourth quarter with a big lead. Yeah, they got him spun around. The ball pops out, and the Colts are able to jump on top of it.
Now, we got one at least attempt.
We had an answer?
It was Deborah Luster.
That is not correct.
That is not the correct answer. It doesn't hurt to guess. We don't.
Yeah, you don't. Yeah. You don't. You don't get points docked from you. If
yeah,
you
we
have the
we
wrong
don't
answer.
Limit. We don't limit the. Is it in Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Final question. Snaps away. Tillis takes it off the left side. Picks up good first down yardage.
Yeah, good job. Good job by Tillis there to break it up.
Also got on the injured list tonight, Brooks Lewis. I think he had a little knee surgery yesterday. I think he came through it. Got some work to do to get back ready for baseball season, but we wish him luck. And hope to see him out here on the sidelines. We need somebody barking at these guys to get them going in the right direction. Second and seven. Snaps back. We're going to try to pass. We're going to try to hit. He hits. Good pass. Hits Redwine.
Yeah, nice to see him letting Antisi sling it a little bit out there. And he hits Redwine in stride. Great job by Redwine again, getting open and using his big frame to give the quarterback a target. And he hits him in stride. Good job by both Antisi and Redwine there.
9 minutes to go. Man, I keep forgetting to click over this quarter. I'm always a half a quarter
We're
behind.
Still in the third quarter?
Bob. Yeah. I switched tonight. First and 10, Colts. Harrison motion. Snaps away. Give on the backside to Tillis. And he'll be bottled up for no gain.
Yeah, you mentioned injuries early, Bobby. I did speak to Brad Jennings before the game tonight.
Yep.
He said he is progressing. I think he's got, another checkup coming. So hopefully he continues to move forward past that concussion. Wish all the best for Brad Jennings and hope his early return to the field.
Second and 10. Snaps away. We're going to give on the speed play to Harris. And he tries to get the edge and doesn't make it there.
Number 22, Brown Harris on the carry.
Number six gets a paw on him and brings him down.
Yeah, he showed good speed earlier, but they got a hand on his shoulder pad there, got a jersey, and they go to wrangle him up, bring him down.
Missed tackle there, and he's probably still running. Ah, we got a winner.
Oh, we got a winner in trivia?
Yeah. Somebody maybe did some research here because they even got the spelling right, and there's no way he knew that. No way.
Is that John Seeley?
Yeah,
is that
John Seeley.
So we got an answer to a trivia question from John Seeley.
We'll just use the maiden name. First homecoming queen was Faye Ritchie.
Good job by John Seeley getting the correct answer there.
You know, John was a good bit under me in school. He excelled in open book tests.
In open book tests, that's where he was really good.
He was
at,
good at open book. Closed book, he had a tough time.
It's a little bit like his golf game. Needs a little help every now and then.
Jonathan Flowers came in with the correct answer, but he was a little late. Well, if Chris Lively don't want his, I say we give Chris's. Time has expired.
Yeah, Chris never came to see me and pick up his gift card last week or this week.
Yeah, we're going to give that one to Jonathan Flowers. Snaps away. Kick is up. It's a driving kick. It's going to get – oh. He tried to do the fair catch but muffed the punt. Gets on it. First and 10, Lions.
Yeah, really good driving deep punt by Walker there. Good job on the boot. And he muffs it, but he was able to get back on top of it. So the Lions will retain possession here.
Well, Seeley's giving compliments to his wife on the answer. That makes a lot more sense.
So we give it to her. So he's not allowed to get the – okay.
I think Seeley – I think you call that marrying up. Yeah. He may have outkicked his coverage.
Outkicked his
one.
Coverage, yeah. Out of his league a little bit.
First and 10 Lions. All right, clock's rolling. We're under 5.5 minutes. So, young guy's getting some time in. Who else we got out there? Snaps away. I think we got yards out there. All right. Oh! Trey V, Treverian Curtis in on the breakup pass.
Yeah, great job by the anticipation there by number 11 coming in. He gets there the same time the ball does. Nearly gets the pick. Good job on coverage by number 11.
All right, that's 60 Webb Bullock in at defensive tackle. We also got Ben Pennington in there and Woo-Woo Lively at linebacker.
I do want to give a shout-out to all those that are still watching and listening to us. We understand the score of the game and where we are in it. So we've ticked up in listeners since halftime, so we appreciate everybody tuning in.
Snaps away, handoff up the middle. And it looks like Burton's going to get there. No, that's Lively going to get there. Wrestling down to the ground, gain of about 5 on the play.
Yeah, good job by Warner Lively getting in there and getting him at the point of contact and getting him down.
All right, we're down to 3:50 to go.
A big run off the left side here for the Lions.
Yeah,
he breaks it outside.
Montavian's there is going to run him down and try to strip it and knock him out of bounds around the 30-yard line.
Again, I mentioned it before, but just glad to see that such a good effort by the Lions there. They're continuing to play hard. Well, Bobby, you know, this game's pretty much in hand.
I'm glad to see you get your first win.
I'm getting my first win, so
if we lost tonight, you were going to be fired.
I'll bring it up after this play here. We'll let this play take place.
Oh, that's Sawyer Hummer in the backfield, number 14, along with Bram Harris.
Yeah, great job by Sawdog there, getting in there and taking the quarterback down for a big hit. He just came clean right off the edge and a beeline to the quarterback, and he takes him down for a big sack. So the Bulldogs are at home this weekend. Big matchup between the Bulldogs and the Tigers, Bobby.
Yeah,
are you going over there to root on your boys?
I'll be there. I mean, it's 11 o'clock kickoff. I think they shut the road down about 9 o'clock. So we got the tent, so we're probably going to have to leave.
You'll be okay, yeah.
I may have to leave about 4 o'clock.
So. In the morning?
Yeah, it's gonna be a rough morning. Hand off right side. Artis. And who's that? That's Dixon in on the stop.
Yeah, good job by Artis and Owen Dixon getting him stopped in the backfield there. Yeah, you're headed to Starkville. I'll be headed the other way. I'm headed to Oxford tomorrow to catch the Rebels and Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets.
Well, I wish them luck.
Any chance the
I'm talking about the Yellow Jackets.
Yeah, I know. Any chance the Bulldogs going to pull it out against the Tigers this weekend?
No way. No way.
Come on, Bobby.
All right, down to the last couple snaps. Dixon's going to get him down. It'll bring up fourth down.
In on the stop, number 61, Owen Dixon.
That's what you hate to see there. Late in the game, they're beginning all the effort. Little injury. Ah, they get him up. He's going to be okay. Maybe an ankle situation there for number 6 for the Lions.
All right, there's the Lewis crew at home. Willie, Maggie. Brooks, wishing Brooks a speedy recovery.
Yeah, we hope Brooks heals quickly. Good luck on his recovery.
I'm sure Brooks will love that.
Yeah.
Willie will get a kick out of it. All right, fourth and 14. 28 seconds. And they're going to just try to get to the edge. Curtis is out there. Sawdog's going to get him down for about a two-yard gain. Yeah. Lions will turn it over downs, but that's probably going to run out the clock. We're down to 15 seconds. Homecoming next week. Junior High will be on the road. Two big games. Y'all come support the Colts.
I want to thank everybody for listening and watching, and thanks for helping me get my first win of the season, Bobby. Enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Glad to be here for a win, finally.